This sleepy town in southern England is not the sort of place you'd expect to find international rock stars walking the streets. However...
Hi there, my name's Martin Smith and I'm in my hometown of Rustington, West Sussex. You probably don't know me, but in a couple of days' time, the band I'm in, we're going to be playing before 15,000 people in America, a place where we outsell Robbie Williams 2-1. Check it out.
Delirious are a bit different from other British rock bands. They're more famous abroad than here at home. They think nothing of making a 24-hour trip to California just to play one gig. Also, all five members of the band are Christians, who are not afraid to explore their faith in their music.
And it's a new entry next for Delirious, a band whose name might be a little unfamiliar to you. Maybe the best-kept secret in pop until today. Delirious at number 20.
The band's first mainstream success came in 1997. Their song Deeper came from nowhere to enter the chart at number 20.
I wanna go deeper, but I don't know how to swim. I wanna be maker, but have you seen this old earth?
We were all around at Tim's house. There's about 45 of us, all crammed into his little front room. And we had the little radio on, and I remember Spice Girls were in at 21. And then our song came on at 20, a new band, Delirious, pop's best kept secret or whatever. And you're trying not to be excited and you're just freaking out and everyone around you's like...
Yeah. It was like, it's just scored the winning goal.
And you're
it?
Running like, yeah, I love you, man, I love you. I just, you know, I love you. And that... just lasted with you for a week, and thinking then that that was it, you all of a sudden you're the biggest band in the world, and then a week later realising...
It's number 36.
Yeah, 30 dropping out and you've got a lot of work to do.
Their next song, Promise, also broke the top 20. Delirious sold out gigs from Brighton to Belfast, and played some of the biggest stadiums in the UK on tour with Bon Jovi. At one Wembley concert, 80,000 people came to see them at a Christian festival. The other unusual thing about Delirious is that from the very start, they've released all their records themselves under their own label, Furious, based at Arundel. 6 years and seven albums later, what was a cottage industry has become a global business.
Hi, I'm Tony Potato. I'm the manager of Delirious and the boss of Furious Records. Come on inside, let me give you a tour. This is the record label and press department for the world. We handle all of our distribution contracts and press from Australia to Ukraine, which is a new signing, to America and the UK. Here's our royalty area and accounting department, our manufacturing and our merchandising, which is a big earner for us. There's our design area. Dan and Mark deal with all the design of record sleeves and leaflets and posters, CD-ROMs and videos. Let me take you downstairs. This is the distribution area where we have fast picking lines, where we have 144 different lines, which is CDs, T-shirts, songbooks, what have you, getting into 450 stores around the UK and over 90 countries around the world. Tim has packed every box that's left out of here. This is the area where we store all the band's gear, where we have all the full recording capabilities to record albums in nice stately homes or anywhere we like. And of course, all the gear for us to tour around the world, whether it's guitars, amplifiers, what have you. Not bad from a band starting out in a little school hall down the road.
We formed about 10 years ago now,
We're all local Littlehampton boys. We started playing together in a small school hall. It was actually a church event that we were running called Cutting Edge. First night, 75 kids turned up.
Word of mouth meant the band's audiences doubled every time they played. Soon they moved from the drama room to the school hall, then onto the sports centre, and then they needed an even bigger arena.
Here we are down on Littlehampton seafront, and back in the early days we used to meet here and do free gigs on the seafront. I can remember the first time we did it, we had 2,000 people come and we were selling our tapes out the back of the estate car down there on the grass. The second time we had 4,000 people and then a couple of flatbed trucks for the stage. And the third time we did it, we had a big dome covered stage with 10,000 people turn up, filled up this whole grassy area. And that was about the kind of time when we were thinking, you know, we should be going for this thing full time.
The band hopes their latest album will widen their British audience. Back in 97, Radio 1 dubbed Delirious pop's best kept secret. Ironically, Radio 1 have helped keep it that way, with a reluctance to play the band's records. But despite the lack of airplay, Delirious have had 7 singles in the top 40. It's OK went to number 16. They get good reviews in the music press. So why, with their appeal growing round the world, is it such hard going in the UK? Maybe this country has problems seeing the words Christian and rock in the same sentence.
I think Christian music probably does have a stigma attached to it, because I think there's a lot of associations of songs of praise or those kinds of images. You know, my old image would be very much like of a acoustic guitar, socks and sandals and a rainbow strap, you know, thinking that's what people think.
6 years ago when we released Deeper, or whenever that was, I think there was a lot of hostility and a lot of like, I love the music but just don't give me that Christian thing, you know, it's just freaking me out. I can't play it on radio and I'm going to lose my job if I do. People saying, well, man, if only you'd write about girls, you know, you'd be massive, you know. And we've done a little bit of that. It's okay, you know I'll live to fight another day. It's okay, you know I'll live to find the words to say.
So what about sex, drugs and rock and roll?
What does that mean? Drugs, I mean, you know, there's no bigger high than playing on stage with your mates in a band, seeing 10,000 people sing along to your song. You know, sex, well, that's fine. There's enough for me at home.
We went on tour with quite a large world act, and we were sort of told by our tour manager at one of their initiations to take the support band out to a strip club. There was a few discussions about that, but it never came to anything. I think it was a hoax.
I went, didn't you?
The other rock and roll bit, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, we're doing that every
day,
aren't we?
Yeah.
That's right. We are rock and roll. Look at us.
We do often turn up at venues and the runner introduces themselves. They say, you know, I'm your runner for today, you know, I can get you anything.
Yeah.
And you're like, no, you know, we're doing good. Or someone says, yeah, I'd love a bottle of water. You know, he comes back and he's like, yeah, I'll get you anything.
Blue Smarties.
Yeah. Almost had to spell it out to us, you know, anything, you know, and we're like, yeah, no, we're fine, thanks.
I mean, people call us squeaky clean or whatever, but, you know, we still like the odd half pint of lager.
Really? What, but maybe with a bit of lemonade in.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Q magazine points up why artists like Delirious can face a problem.
We've pretty much worked out now that it's best to be yourself, you know, and that's, you know, we've probably made some mistakes along the way and tried to sort of, you know, camouflage things a little bit and, you know, tone things down just to sort of appease people. And but at the end of the day, it doesn't really work because we are who we are and, you know, we're proud of who we are and what we believe.
We'd like to have
a good effect on people, and to make them ask questions about it. And you know, we're not saying that we're the ones to come and do the preaching, but we're trying to be non-confrontational, but true to ourselves at the same time.
We want to sing about things that make sense to everyone, but at the same time, we don't want to water that down and pretend that we're something that we're not.
What's coming out of us is what God has put into us. And that might seem like a grandiose comment, but that is, I think, how we feel.
Great musicians and great bands just have to be themselves. And I think you look back at all the great rock and roll bands of the various times, I think they've all stood for something different. They believed in something that made them different, or they did something that made them different. And could that be our calling card? Maybe.
The band are off to Sacramento, California, to headline a Christian youth event for 15,000 people. But it's no holiday. The band leaves Heathrow Friday lunchtime to come back Sunday night. A 58-hour round trip, 40 hours in transit, and 18 hours spent in Sacramento. But it's nothing compared to some of their previous journeys.
Yeah, the worst long-haul travelling experience we've ever done, I think, is we went to New Zealand for a day. And I don't recommend anyone doing it. It is nuts. It's like 20... Well, it's 2 days to get there and 2 days to get back.
Yeah.
And, you know, my legs haven't been the same since.
No. It was my idea to go to New Zealand in for one day, for one concert.
It's what we said to him when we got back. Yeah. It was the interesting thing.
Tony often comes with us, but he wasn't on that trip. Funny enough.
Mm. All five of us are married now. And I think we have about 12 children between us. It's a real balancing act, you know. If you're away too much, then your children don't know your name when you walk in the door. We've kind of got a few little rules that we try and keep to about the length of the trips we do, but it does make it mad. I mean, you know, as we said, we're going to America for one gig.
Unfortunately, you can't play to 20,000 Americans in your hometown every weekend.
We will literally fly into Australia, do five shows, and come home again. We won't stay for a day off.
I've been up about 23 hours so far.
Yeah. Well, it's actually not late here. It's half past 8 here, but it's half past 4 in the morning back home, so...
I want to go to bed.
The band finally arrive at their hotel, badly needing sleep. But they'll need to rouse themselves tomorrow to perform for thousands of people.